Hey YouTube, Scottish Claymore here, and today I am bringing you a really awesome opening, in my opinion. So with Elemental Dragons, obviously, have taken off, and one of their main cards is Goldstark. Well, I actually went and bought a box of Special Edition Duelist Revs. So there's 10 Special Editions in here, and they are... One of the promo cards is Goldstark, and the other is Drill Warrior. So, you know, this set is awesome, and of course they come with three packs of Duelist Revolution. Duelist Revolution is probably one of my more favorite sets from the 5Ds era. It's a really imbalanced set, though, because, like, it doesn't have too many... while I'm talking, I'm going to open this. It doesn't have too many, great common cards or anything like that, but it does have some awesome holos. In particular, Effect Veiler and Solemn Warning, I believe, are in this. So let's open this up, and we'll open up the 10 Duelist Revs. I mean, part of it is just getting the Gold Starks themselves are kind of worth it. Now, each one of these is actually sealed by Konami, so if you don't have, like, if you get a box and they're not sealed inside, they're not actually legit, and they could be scaled or whatever. So the actual individual special editions are sealed by Konami. So it's just a heads up for this set. I'm going to actually take them all out so that, you know, we just, I'm going to keep them in order, I think, here, or as much as I can. Just because we have limited camera space, shall we say. So there we go. I'm going to open them up one at a time, and we'll do all the packs at once. So we'll do the promos first, so I'm just going to move them off to the side here. Just so I wanted you guys to see that there are 10 in here. And I'm, you know, obviously, Drill Warrior is actually not a bad card now to get either, because he's going to get a lot of play, I think, in the Blue Eyes decks, Blue Eyes Synchron decks, because that deck is actually a lot of fun. When that set comes out, it's going to be a fun-ass time. And I can already see that this is a Gold Sark. Awesome. I'm hoping for, like, 6-4, maybe, but it'll probably, you know, who knows. Maybe 6-4 the wrong way. So I'm going to set the packs. I guess I'll do what I usually do and set them sort of, like, by themselves on, like, lined up so that we can see which, how many of the special editions here have holos in them. So who knows? Obviously, a holo is a holo, so, you know, I'd like to get some secret rares from this set, because I don't have any. I don't think I have any secret rares from this set. And the next one is a Drill Warrior. So there we go. Again, I'm not too upset about, like, Drill Warriors being pulled, because I know that they're going to be used in that deck. The junk Blue Eyes or whatever it is, that deck is a lot of fun to play. So much fun. With the Azure Maiden, it just basically breaks the deck. and it gets Quasar out really easily. Probably more easier than levels, because you don't need to set up as much. And the next one is another Drill Warrior. Oh no. Alright, let's try to go a little faster here. I know, you guys don't want to have to see a huge long video, if possible. I mean, the packs themselves, there's going to be 30 packs, so who knows how long that's going to take to open. I think on my last one it was, another Drill Warrior. Oh, shit. Man, I'm hoping to at least get a playset of Gold Starks here. You know, that would be nice. Secret rare Gold Starks, I mean, super rare Gold Starks are always nice. I think they're going for, like, $10 each right now. Just because, you know, they're hollowed out. Oh, good, another Gold Stark, okay. There we go, that's 5 special editions. Sorry, I'll move the packs up in a second once I get the promos out of the way. Yeah, so, I meant to do this in another video, but I want to thank my subscribers for subscribing. You guys, thank you for all the support, and I know the camera's shitty for everybody who comments on it. I'm sorry, I really am. I don't have the money right now to be going out and buying a new HD camera just for this purpose at this moment. But, you know, at some point in the future, hopefully. You know, so. Plus, I'd rather spend the money on the actual cards so that you guys can see more openings. And another Gold Sark. Awesome. I see them. They don't... I believe in the European ones, what they do is they actually, like, put it underneath a piece of cardboard or something like that when you see the promo. So, like, but these ones, you can actually see the promo as you're opening it up, so it kind of ruins the surprise when you're opening them on camera or whatever, even when you're just opening by yourself, because the packs are not, like, sealed tight between the two pieces of plastic. Here, I'll show you what I mean. So, like, here, you can see that there's, like, a green line right here. So you know that it's a Gold Sark, which is awesome, because the packs, like, they're not sealed tight between the two pieces of plastic, so. But hey, can't win them all. Maybe you can catch them all. Who knows? Wow, one of these Gold Series has, like, weird white dots. Oh, no, okay, never mind. It's just, yeah, it's okay. It's just, like, fluff or something. Has anybody ever had that happen to them before? If you're opening, like, older packs, sometimes the picture has degraded a bit, and there's, like, a piece of cardboard. Like, it is, like, a random white dot on the card somewhere. And it's really kind of annoying when you get that, because it ruins the quality, like, the value of the card. And we have a Drill Warrior here. So we are 5 Gold Sarks, 4 Drill Warriors so far. And the last one... One more special edition. Is it going to be a Gold Sark? Because that's actually probably what I would prefer it to be. So I get 2 playsets, ideally. And it is... Oh, it's actually not... It hasn't moved in this one. It is Gold Sark! Awesome! So 2 playsets of Gold Sarks. Each one of these is $10, so that's already like $60 right here worth of cards. I don't know what the Drill Warrior's worth. It's probably not worth that much. But yeah. Here it is, guys. 6 super rare gold sarcophaguses. Awesome. Drill Warrior is probably worth like $1 or $2. So, he's not worth too much. But I wanted them because I'm going to be building that Blue Eyes deck. So, there he is. Anyways, let's move the packs around a bit here so we can see them all. They're also in order of what I opened them, so I'll just open them in order, if that matters. I don't know if it really matters to you guys what order I open them in or whatever. Or if I even bother keeping them sort of separated like this. But, yeah, so this is, like, the first special edition and so on and so forth. So, let's get started opening the packs and see what we pull. I'm only going to go through the commons for, like, a little bit, just because, again, it's just so many of the same ones. Anyway, I'll pull them right up here. Damage Eater. Watt Cannon. Mind Mole. Miracle Synchro Fusion, which is okay. Scrap Golem is a rare. Rhino Taurus. Pestilence. Dash Warrior. Unihorned Familiar. Nothing in that pack, really. I mean, I haven't played Scrap decks in forever, so really there. There are a lot of like rare Scrap cards in here, like an actual rare one. Chain Whirlwind, which is used to be actually not a bad card, but it's not used anymore. Watzine, Monosaurus, Beast Rising, a Dark Desert Appear. Dark Desert Appear is rare. Watt Pheasant, that's actually not a bad common. That's probably one of the best commons in the set. Yeah, I would say that's probably right up there. Flamveil Fiend, Barrier Wave, and Bicorn Ra'eb. Actually, what's interesting about this is that the Fire Kings, the Duelist, the structure deck, the Fire King structure deck, actually reprinted a lot of these commons in that structure deck. I guess because they felt that like Duelist Revolution was really popular when it came out because it had Solemn Warning and Effect Veiler, and it was the only way you could get it for a while. So I guess they felt they needed to reprint it. Like, I think this guy was in it. If not, like, Flamveil Poon. Like, a lot of the Flamveil cards were in it. Flamveil Archer, Desperate Tag, Nocturia Mosquito. Oh, and a Voltic Bicorn, ultra rare. That's pretty cool. And it's an ultra. Doesn't really do anything. It's not very great. But, you know, it's a holo. I'll take it. Okay. Amazonas Scouts is the rare. Beast Rage, another Wad Pheasant. Awesome. Again, I still think Wads are kind of underrated. They're a really good deck. They could use a little bit more support. But yeah, they're alright. Naturia Beans, Dash Warrior, Naturia Mosquito. Okay, we're at the beginning again. So one holo from that special edition. Not bad. Next pack. That just came right apart. We have another Wad Pheasant. This card just loves me, apparently. Naturia Beans, Dash Warrior, Scrap Rage. Wow, Egotistical Ape. The rare. Stronghold Guardian. Watt Cannon, Watt Lemur, which is kind of useless, and Double Cyclone, which is an okay card. Double Cyclone used to also get more play, but not as much now. Next pack. AD Changer. Barrier Wave, Scrap Sheen. Oh, a secret rare, Miracle's Wake. Awesome. Huh. So it's select one monster that was destroyed by battle and sent to your graveyard this turn and special summon it. Actually, I'm actually kind of surprised this card isn't used as much. I guess it's sort of like a bit conditional because it needs to be destroyed by battle. But I can see this actually not being a bad card. Of course, it's really hard to find, so it would have to be reprinted common for it to get any use, really. And a lot of decks may not have a lot of space for it. I guess that could be another issue. DD Destroyer, but it would be an interesting tech to bring out in whatever, you know. Final Psychic Ogre, Desperate Tag, Gen X Worker, Watt Lemur. Yeah, there you go. So I think after this pack, I'm going to stop going through the commons, guys, because this video is going to be, like, freaking excessively long. So yeah. Watt Beta. Scrap Sheen. I mean, we've seen most of them at this point anyway. Queen's Pawn. Amazonas Trainee. Blind Spot Strike, which is not a bad card. Horn of the Phantom Beast. This actually is probably one of the better rares in the set. It's kind of underused. It used to be used a lot more. And it too got reprinted in the Onslaught of the Fire Kings. Mind Mole, Flammable Archer, Howl of the Wild, Monosaurus, yeah, and Blind Spot Strike. We're back to the beginning. Yeah, so. Alright, guys, so we're just going to do rares and holos now, because, you know, I'm kind of tired anyway, and we've seen most of the holos, I mean, the rare, commons, except for Summoning Curse, apparently. So I don't think we've seen that yet. And Flamvel Poon, another reprinted card. Holy shit! Sorry, crap. Another Miracle's Wake, secret rare. That's two secret rares. Wow. Holy crap, two secret rares. And that's the same special edition, guys. That's like two secret rares in one set. That's not the best of secret rares, but wow, holy smokes, two secret rares. Awesome. Guts of Steel is the rare. Wow. Battle Instinct, another common we haven't seen. I guess I'll just go through and point out any commons we haven't seen. Wow, holy crap. Even from, like, a box like this, I know there's no guaranteed ratios. Oh, sorry, that wasn't the same one, but still. From a box like this, you know, you're not guaranteed ratios, and having two secret rares, wow. So, you could theoretically pull, like, no holos except for the promos in these, but let's hope that does. Obviously that's... hasn't happened yet, ideally. And we have Amazon Scouts as a rare. Oh, Elephant is a new common. I mean, most of the commons are really not used. I think there was a deck that used Stronghold Guardian at one point. I'm not sure. Let's see here. We have DD Unicorn Knight as a rare. So far we've had one holo per... Oh, Beast Rage is another common here. One holo per special edition. This is on special edition number 4 now. If I can open it. We have Oh, a Unicorn Beacon, super rare, awesome. And a Synchro Fusionist as the rare. I don't think Synchro Fusionist ever got a whole heck of a lot of play. I think it's like the combos are too much. Basically, it's a card that lets you use a Synchro monster as a material for a Fusion monster. And I believe there's one of the holos in this set is like one of those Fusion monsters that requires a Synchro to work. It was a concept that never really took off because it's just too complicated. Like, it's too easy to beat. I don't think they'll probably go back to it. Maybe they will. Amazon's Willow Piper is a rare. Who knows? Wow, and guys, it is like just pissing rain outside right now. Hopefully it lets up. It seems like it's getting a bit brighter. That's actually part of the reason why the light is kind of a little dark here. It's like super overcast, obviously, if it's raining. And the Chivalry! Awesome! Ultra rare Chivalry! Now, this card, too, also doesn't get a lot of use. It's not that great. It's okay. Activate only during your battle phase. When the effect of an opponent's effect monster is activated, negate the activation and destroy that card. This card has a lot of like limited uses. If I were to play it, it would be like a side deck card, and it could. I think you can use it to stop like Trag and stuff because it works during the battle phase, but I'm not sure about that. You may not be able to activate it in the damage step, but it is a quick play card. So I'd have to look up the ruling on that. But I guess it could have some limited uses. Like certain decks have a lot of effects that activate in the battle phase. So yeah. I think if anything, he's just a side deck card right now. Maybe in the future he'll get more popular. And he's ultra. Hypnocorn is the rare. And nothing spectacular in the commons. On to special edition number 5. So we're one holo per set right now, so far still. And we have a super rare scrap Archfiend. That's an awesome pull. This guy is sort of like the Gem Knight Pearl of Synchros. He's awesome. 7-star, 2700, attack. Good card to have. He's generic. And he's also unaffected by things like Fiendish Chain, because he's not an effect monster. So, he's, again, same thing as Gem Knight Pearl. And another Synchro Fusionist is a rare. That's actually it. I like that pull. I'll take it. It would be awesome to pull, you know, one of the two big cards here, but you never know. Completely random, so. Naturia Pineapple. Secret rare. Wow! That's 3 secret rares. I mean, again, they're not the best secret rares, but wow. 3 secret rares in one of these boxes. Like, normally, if I buy these, I get, like, one. One from the special edition boxes. Amazonas Village is the rare. Wow. Holy smokes. I mean, I've pulled next to no, you know, other holos. I pulled 2 supers and 2 ultras, which is not bad either. Jesus. Apparently, this is not a bad set to buy a special edition of, guys. Like, a full box of them, because, you know, you can get quite a few holos. And now we have Horn of the Phantom Beast rare. Two of those. 2 Phantom Beast's horns. And then now we're on to the back row. So this is special edition number 6. And we have Lightning Tricorn. Wow, another ultra rare. Sweet. That's awesome. And another Amazonas Village is upside down as the rare. Wow, that's crazy. Next pack. I actually kind of wish that the Tricorns and the Unicorns and stuff, like those cards were more useful, because all 3 of them are in this set, and they really work well with each other, but they're not that useful. Hey, Delta Flyer, awesome, that's a good ultra, that's a good rare. Delta Flyer is probably, I would say he's the best tuner for dragons of any kind. Obviously he's not used that much, because the dragons don't use synchros, I mean the E-dragons don't use synchros as much. But he's definitely the best tuner, and he's actually kind of hard to find, because people hoard it, because you never know when dragons, like, if a synchro dragon thing could come back or whatever. Naturia Forest, Reanimation Wave is a rare, just a rare in that pack. I love the artwork on that card, it's one of my top favorite artworks with Revive King, Hades, and Summon Skull. So we're on to number 7 special edition. We have Scrap Hunter, rare. Next pack. Guts of Steel, rare. And the last pack. Oh man. And a Horn of the Phantom Beast. So we have our first bust special edition, guys. No holos in that one. Every other one's given us one holo, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh no, one of them gave us two holos, sorry. So we're still par for the course here. We're on, this is number 8 now that we're opening up. You know, one per pack. And a Thunder Unicorn. So that's all three of the Unicorn cards, guys. That's also three Ultra Rares. Actually, four, if you include Chivalry, Ultra Rares from this set. Three Secret Rares and only two Super Rares. That's really, like, in terms of Ultra, like, rarities, that's hard to do. That's pretty, like, wow. I think Miracle's Wake is actually kind of an underrated card. I'd like to see it get some more play. Scrap Golem is a rare. Next pack. Reanimation Wave is a rare. Next pack. Scrap Beast. That's a new rare. Actually, we haven't pulled that one yet. Okay, on to number 9. Special edition number 9. Synchro Fusionist. Rare. Again. Next pack. Whoa! Another secret rare! That's a Stygian Street Patrol secret rare. Wow! Holy crap. This card also got reprinted. I mean, but it's still probably worth a little bit because it's secret rare. But wow. That's four secret rares, guys. Four secret rares in one special edition box. That's crazy. Amazonas Willowpiper is the rare. Wow! Holy crap! That's actually an awesome card for Infernities. I run it in Infernities at 1. And I actually, I have the reprinted one, so this one will be going into my deck to sort of, you know, to rarity, higher rarity. Wow, that's awesome. And the last pack for number 9, special edition number 9, a Delta Flyer, rare. That's a good rare. Actually, I would say that's probably the best rare in this set. I think I may have already said that, sorry, never mind. I'm pretty sure I already said that, but that's definitely the best rare in this set. Last special edition, guys. 3 packs to go here. Who knows what we'll pull. And an Amazonas Shamanism. Super rare. Wow. And an Ambitious Gopher is a rare. Hate that card. It loves me. I'm actually surprised I haven't pulled more of them. It loves me in the battle packs. I always get it as, like, a rare. In every, like, group of battle packs I buy, I always get it as a rare. And I hate it, because it's such a useless card, in my opinion. Hey! An Ultra! Solemn Warning! Wow. Awesome. Man, this box is awesome. How many freaking holos have I pulled here? That's crazy. And the funny thing is that, like, I've only pulled 3 super rares, and I have more, I have 5 ultra rares. I actually have more secret rares than I do super rares from this whole box. That's crazy. Wow, this box is awesome, guys. Okay, I would suggest if you can get it at a decent price, pick up a special edition of this. There's, like, you can get Gold Sark as your promo, you know, usually at least, like, 5 of them. And then you get, like, how many holos have I pulled? Wow, holy crap. And 4 of them are secret rare, which is just insane. I've never gotten 4 secret rares out of 1 special edition box like this. Normally I get, like, 1. Sometimes I get none. Wow. Another Synchro Fusionist is a rare, if I haven't mentioned that already. I'm just in shock. And the last pack, guys. Last pack. Let's see what we pull. I mean, I don't need to pull anything else more at this point. I'm like, wow, I'm just in shock. And Landoy's Luminous Moss as a rare. So nothing special in that pack. But wow, and like second last pack, pulled the Solemn Warning, which is actually the card I wanted to pull. That or Effect Veiler. So yeah, guys, wow, let's do a recap here real fast. We'll do them in order of rarity. I didn't pull any ultimates, though. Which usually happens, like, if you get a box of packs, it usually happens if you pull two secrets, you don't get the ultimate. So, I'm not surprised on that I didn't, like, especially pull, like, four secrets. But, wow, four secret rares in one box, that's insane. That's just crazy. Yeah, so anyway, let's recap. We have, for our secret rares, four of them, Citrine Street Patrol, Naturia Pineapple, and two Miracle Wakes as our secret rares. Which is freaking awesome. So for ultras, we have an Ultra Solemn Warning. An Ultra Thunder Unicorn. Actually, you know what? I should do that one last. Ultra Chivalry. And then we got all three unicorns, guys, of this set. Unicorn, Bicorn, Voltic Bicorn, and Lightning Tricorn. All in the same set. That's crazy. Crazy, crazy. And then we have three super rares, one of which is awesome. We have, Amazon Shamanism. We have Unicorn Beacon, so we have basically all the unicorn cards. Unicorn Beacon plus the three unicorns. It doesn't get any better than that in terms of that deck. And then the generic Scrap Archfiend, awesome level 7. I still, if I'm running any sort of synchro deck that makes level 7s easy, I like to have him. Black Rose is good as well, of course, but if there's something that makes level 7s really easily, like for Black Wings, I like having him as an out, just because he's 2700, and the Black Wing monsters aren't that powerful, so he's there as a level 7 if I need him. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you like what you saw today, which I sure as hell hope you did, man. I guess we could have pulled, you know, the Effect Veiler and the Solemn Warning, but we did pull an Ultra Solemn Warning, at least, and four secret rares. That's just unheard of. And, you know, I think maybe this set has, like, weird ratios like that, but wow, that's awesome. Plus, of course, we have our four Drill Warriors and six, count them, six Gold Sarcophaguses. So yeah, guys, I guess it's a sarcophagi. Anyways, like, subscribe, leave a comment, as I already said. While I'm repeating myself, in that case, I'm just going to say thanks for watching, guys. Again, thank you to all my subscribers for watching and supporting my videos, and I will see you guys in the next video.